everyone, this is Shirobhi and welcome back to my YouTube channel, that is my booktube channel, Caffeinated Tutor. So first of all, I would like to clarify that you might be thinking that why I'm dressed in so traditional attire and all. There is nothing special, I just had the mood of giving myself the Indian vibes, typical festive season vibes, and so here is the bangles and all the Indian wear. I really love Indian wear, so that's the reason I just felt like doing a video and I had the mood of Indian festivity today, so that's the reason I did it. Okay, coming to today's video, I'll be saying you about all the books I read in this month, and I'll be saying about the series I also saw in this month, so that you know pretty much my taste in series and books. And note that you might be thinking that it's Caffeinated Reader, it should be all about books, I know it, but since series also unfolds a story, series has a story, and story is an art, so I felt like if you see the series, you will be interested to know more about it, and I really felt the story is so beautiful, so I'd be recommending you the series. You might want to see it, and do suggest me some good series if you want to. So yes, since it's going to be long, without any further delay, let's get started into today's video. So the first book that I read in this month was this book called Recovery of Fate by Dr. S. Radhakrishnan. And I have talked about it in great detail in Teacher's Day special recommendation, and I won't talk about it much in this video. So if you want to know more about it, do check out my video. I'll put it in the description box below, the link. And I really loved reading it. Frankly speaking, I have not completed the full of it. It was 15-20 pages left to complete it because I was having some academic stress and I wanted to diversify my read, and it was getting heavy on my head, and I wanted to diversify my read and read something light, refreshing and new, and so that's the reason I didn't complete it. But rather than that 15-20 pages, I got a pretty much good idea about what it was about, and I really loved it because it was my first Sir Radhakrishnan's book I read, and it was good. It was kind of a breath of fresh air because it showed many good ideas on ideologies and thought process, and it was an introspective book. I really loved it. Do check out my Teacher's Day recommendation video in case you want to know about this book. So yes, this was my first book I read in this month, Recovery of Fate by Dr. Radhakrishnan. Now the second book that I completed in this month was this short story called The Hen Who Dreamed She Could Fly by Sunmai Huang. And I recommended this book in my Women's Author Special Celebration, that Exploring Genre one, Women Author Celebration book and video. And trust me on this, this is one of the best short stories I have ever read. The author so beautifully merged the emotions of love, compassion, sympathy, motherhood, fatherly love, and everything between the animal world and the human world. The fact that a child is a child, no matter whether it is of your own blood or another blood, if you are raising it with all your love and care, is so vividly expressed in this book. How the hen who never thought she could lay an egg and how she becomes a mother, this is something beyond thinking. We can't, like, let me say it, the author has so beautifully represented it. In place of the hen, you could have dreamt it in, or you could have imagined a person or a human being, because it is so explicitly explained that the hen is kind of an allegory, or the hen is kind of a metaphor used for the human beings, and it is so beautiful. The author has vividly explained the fact that whether it is humans or whether it is animals, the love and the care of motherhood and fatherly love is always the same, no matter whichever creature it is, whether they can speak our language or whether not. And there were moments I extremely loved. The ending was tragic, but at the same time so peaceful, like the whole journey of one person, of a mother, showed in such a timeline. Very beautiful. Do read this story, and it is a South Korean story and translated to English, and I actually loved it. This is so beautiful. It was a bestseller in its time, so you can imagine it was how good. And it was written in 2000s, and now it's 2020, and the fact that the emotions are so vividly present now is so vivid. Now the third book that I completed in this month was this short story, and it is called Before the Coffee Gets Cold by Toshikazu Kawaguchi. And it's a time travel story sprinkled with magical realism. So It's an amazing story in one word, if I need to say it. I really loved it. It's a Japanese story translated into English and it's very beautiful. We are presented with four narrators who have their own reasons to go into past and change to witness some people or some incident for the last time, and they have one rule. They have many rules basically, but one prime rule is they have to come to present before the coffee gets cold or there are severe consequences waiting for them. And throughout the story, the author has presented before us what is the last thing, or who will be the last person we would want to meet, even though we know that we can never alter the past, because the rule is you can go into past, you can be in the past, but you can never alter the past because the present is already determined. It's very beautiful, very interesting and very heartwarming. I extremely love this book, and this book teaches you many things. Often the things we ignore, you might regret later or feel guilty about, but this book teaches you a lot about these stuffs, how you can actually control some things, because that might be the last time you would be meeting that person without knowing it, and how every second you spend with the person should be beautiful enough, because you never know when it is going to be the last. So yes, this was the third book that I completed in this month before the coffee gets cold. Now the next book that I completed in this month was this book known to everybody, and it is The Diary of a Young Girl by Anne Frank. Now let me say one thing. Don't read this diary as a diary of a victim or a Holocaust survivor. Read this diary of a person who has got this tremendous faith and belief and strength in her character, in her attitude and in her mind and heart. I really didn't know how strong a lady she was unless I read it. She was 14-15 years old when the Holocaust hit her and she witnessed the worst of the humankind. But the strength she exposed, the strength she displayed is beyond the capacity of even some 20 years old. I could relate to her in many instances because she is an extrovert, she was an extrovert fun loving girl. She loved to travel, she loved to explore, and I relate to her in all those situations, and there are many instances where I could feel her. Had she survived, she would have been one of the greatest journalists or writer the world ever produced, because she wanted to be one. And throughout the book, I am not a person who annotates, but let me just show you. Throughout the book, I annotated so many parts that I couldn't control myself without annotating. Here's one, then here's another. So throughout the book, it's the same. I have annotated so many parts and I really loved it. I would urge anyone and everyone, please do read her book, because she is an epitome of strength, courage, and she has displayed strength in the worst of times and how you can be grateful and graceful even in those situations. And if I go on saying about this book, it wouldn't end, because it has personally manifested a great side of goodness in me. So I would really keep that all to myself, because some things are not expressible. But yes, I would really urge you to give a read to this book. Now the next books that I read or I'm reading in this month, because these are not yet finished, is this book. First one is this book called Siddhartha by Hermann Hesse. Yes, you guessed it correctly. If you have guessed, this is the book I bought in my first unboxing video I showed you all, and I am quite enjoying it because it is a fiction plus spiritual kind of a book, and the annotation part is the same as I have said, because I generally don't annotate, but sometimes I feel there are so many things that I need to know and I need to remember, so I just annotate so that next time I visit it, I just swipe up and see the main parts of it. And I'm really enjoying it because it is not the typical fictional story. It has spiritual inclinations in it, and I'm enjoying it. So I will give a review of this book. I have thought about it once I'm done with this book. So yes, this is also my current going read. Now coming to the series part, first of all let me say, you guys, I am not a series person, but this lockdown has made me watch some good series, and I will be saying the three series I have watched or am watching in this September month, so that you get a bit of taste about what type of things I like. Typically I love time traveling, science fiction, reality based, romance, everything, but I will be saying about the September month only. So yes, do say me if you have seen any of the three, or if you like any of the three, then we are friends in the taste. So the first series that I saw in this month was this amazing Indian series called Bandish Bandits, and don't tell me you don't like it, please, because this is so 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 good. Like, it has my heart. Be it Tamanna or be it Radha, both have portrayed their characters so beautifully, and the conflict of pop culture and Indian classical music and the blending, this is so beautiful. Really, I was amazed. I was postponing it. I thought, okay, I'll see. But once I saw it, I just regretted so much. I ended up watching it 3 times. Can you imagine? I ended up watching it 3 times. I really loved it. The entire scenario, the song composition, the vibrancy, the cinematic environments, the chemistry between both Tamanna and Radhe, their singing chemistry between the both, this is so beautiful. I just can't wait for the second season to come. Really, I'm so so pleased. And the songs, Couple Goals or any other, the Cherkhaniya and all these are so amazing. I really loved it. Yes, so do tell me in the comment box below if you love these songs, because I really love the series and the songs. Now the next series that I watched in this month was this series called Modern Love. When it is Emmy nominated, and this is also a very amazing story. It was a binge watching for me, random binge watching. I just ended up playing it, and trust me, there are 8 episodes, and each episode gives a different perspective and different concept of love from different angles, and all the concepts are so important in our today's life. I recommended it to one of my friends. She is a very interested one in this series and these stuffs, and she really loved it. So I hope you will love it too, in case you are into this series which gives you different angles and perspectives and all that things. And I really loved it. This is very amazing. So the next series that I watched in this month was this series called Modern Love. And the current ongoing series that I'm watching is this series called Bizzoli and Isles. It is based on Tess Gerritsen's detective novel characters, Maura Isles and Jane Bizzoli. I have read her novels and I so love it. And the series is equally interesting with its gruesome murders and gruesome accidents. And Dr. Isles, the diva-like doctor, medical examiner, and Jane Bizzoli, the homicide detective, both trying their best to come up with the solution and the answer to the murders. Practically and personally, I felt that Maura Isles is shown as a woman who is quite more extrovert, but in the book that Tess Gerritsen wrote, she was more into the introvert kind of. Other than that, I have no complaint with the series. This is fantastic. Do give it a watch if you want to see some gruesome, heart-wrenching and all that type of series, but at the same time having some soft, beautiful queens as the main characters. And by the way, all of these series are in Amazon Prime, because I have the subscription of Amazon Prime. So in case you want to see it, you have the subscription of Amazon Prime, you watch it there. Coming to positive quote of today. Today's positive quote is, "It always seems impossible until it is done," by Nelson Mandela. So if you're in that phase of your life, because lockdown has made many of think in that way, that you are not worthy of success, family, love and anything good and beautiful, don't see it or don't think like this. Don't see the life in that way. It always seems impossible until it is done. Whether it is a career or whether having a good life, it always seems impossible if you are not into that phase, because success doesn't come so easily. So yes guys, this was it. If you like my video, do give a like, comment what you liked and what you didn't like, share it with your friends, family, close ones and anybody you think would love to watch it, anybody who might be interested. Subscribe to my channel, because I post every week and you might be wanting to see more. So yes guys, do like, share, comment, subscribe to all the good things that is necessary to make me and make my channel grow. Till the next time, bye bye.